This is a typical farmhouse from a 19th century Brazilian coffee plantation. The masters lived in the so-called Casa Grande, the big house, while the slaves were confined to their quarters, called senzalas. Here, the senzala was in the big house's basement. The current owner, who bought and restored the property in the early 1980s, also found some of the chains used to restrain the slaves. Luizinho Santos also has a collection of documents from that period, salvaged right before they were about to be trashed in the small town of Paraibuna in São Paulo's countryside. These are historic documents from the times of slavery in Brazil. And actually, these ones that I'm seeing now are, I have this one, these are receipts for the payment of taxes on the purchase of a slave. So for example, this one is from 1874, and that's Guido de Andrade paying 30,000 reais, it's the currency of Brazil at that time, for the purchase of slave Justiniano.
We can't hide these kinds of things. It's better to bring to the surface things that were hidden. For example, researching the story of my family, I found out that when my great-great-grandmother died in the 1830s, her inventory included slaves owned by the family. We cannot lie about the history. My family in the past condoned slavery. I don't.
It is estimated that more than 4 million African slaves were brought to Brazil between the 16th and the 19th centuries. Over the years, thousands of slaves who escaped their masters established so-called quilombo communities. The biggest and best known of them was the Quilombo dos Palmares, led by Zumbi dos Palmares, depicted in a 1980s movie. The day of Zumbi's death, November 20th, is now officially marked as the Day of Black Consciousness in Brazil. It wasn't until the late 1980s that Brazil began to recognize the rights of runaway descendants to Quilombo lands. Here in the Quilombo da Fazenda, on the coast of São Paulo, this community of 80 families has been trying for years to get the permanent deeds for land already recognized as theirs. They organize workshops to show outsiders, often university students, their traditional ways. For example, how to build mud houses or how to plant in the middle of the forest without having to clear it.
Então hoje pra gente é muito importante.
Reaffirming our land rights and our culture is very important for us. We need to see our right to housing guaranteed and to have land for our crops because we want to continue living off our agriculture and not have to rely on the cities and industries for our survival.
According to official statistics, African Brazilians, either black or of mixed race, account for more than half of Brazil's population. And the segment's slave roots are often cited as a primary reason for lagging behind the whites, both economically and socially. According to the most recent government data from 2015, 70% of African Brazilians are considered poor or vulnerable, compared to about 46% of the white population. Wages for white families are nearly double that of black families. White Brazilians over age 15 have an average 9 years of education, compared to just under 7.5 years for black Brazilians. And blacks are far more illiterate. More than 9 million over the age of 15, compared to 3.6 million whites. This NGO, a black activist movement, tries to help poorer Brazilians get an education and enter into university. Despite the quota system, black presence in higher education remains well below white enrollment.
Brazil began with a story of 400 years of slavery. This has made deep marks in Brazilian society that are visible, even if often denied. That's why black activist movements say reparation is needed on all levels. The fact that the wealth in Brazil is concentrated in half a dozen millionaire families and the middle class, which is almost exclusively white, shows that we actually have a continuation of slavery and that the abolition of it was fake.
Since slavery was abolished, African Brazilians have been working to reclaim their identity and fighting for social and economic equality. While there have been advances, what is clear 130 years later is there is still much to do to close Brazil's racial gap. Paulo Cabral, CGTN, São Paulo.